Just little things. The good news, though, friends, we don't have to worry about any foggy starts in the near future, basically because we're going to be dealing with some breezier conditions here the next couple of mornings. So that'll be just enough to help stir up the atmosphere and prevent any fog from developing here in Southwest Florida. As for those temperatures today, running a bit above average by a few degrees. In Fort Myers, we hit a high of 88. The normal is 85. Cape Coral hit 86. Punta Gorda, that was our hot spot, hitting 89 degrees today, along with Naples. And Golden Gate recorded an afternoon temperature of 87 degrees. Now, those temperatures, they're cooling a bit, but still on the warm side, mid-80s. Check out that dew point, the measure of moisture in the air. It is nice and low, humidity at just 43%. And it's more or less picture perfect, in my opinion, this evening. Let's take a live look outside right now from the Fox 4 studios as we look across Cape Coral. And we do have those high, thin, cirrus clouds up there, but that's about it. They're close to where planes fly, right around 30,000 feet or so. But I mentioned on the muggy meter that we are in the comfy range. Anytime we're talking about dew points around 60 degrees, close to 50s, definitely feeling quite nice indeed. We don't have to factor in that extra heat index, for example. Now, typically, the drier air leads to a cooler start, but we're going to have a bit of a breeze tomorrow morning, around 15 miles per hour. That'll be just enough to stir up the air a bit and prevent our temperatures from dropping closer to that dew point. So we can expect morning lows for the next 7 days or so, running in the upper 60s, pretty close to that average, which is 68 for this time of year. So heading into tomorrow, the biggest threat, the biggest concern weather-wise, that will be gusty winds. We'll start to see those winds increase mid to late morning, and then gusts to 25 miles per hour are likely throughout the week. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, even heading into the weekend, breezy conditions are forecast. Each evening, those winds will become a bit lighter, continuing through the morning, and then mid to late morning, they'll start to increase each and every day. The biggest takeaway from this, if you have beach and boating plans, just something to keep in mind, because choppy conditions are definitely expected for those inland waterways for our boaters, for example, tomorrow. So looking ahead to your hour by hour outlook tomorrow morning right here at 7 a.m. Things nice and quiet for that morning commute. Lots of sunshine on the horizon. But with that flow picking up out of the east and northeast, that will basically shove all of this Atlantic moisture right here into Southwest Florida. That in turn will increase our cloud cover a bit for the afternoon heading into the evening. Partly to mostly cloudy skies are expected. Could squeeze out an isolated shower, but overall those showers will be few and far between. A healthy soaking rain, just not in the cards as the dry season has officially arrived. So for tomorrow, mostly sunny, breezy. We'll hit a high around 86 degrees or so. As for those winds, they will be increasing again mid to late morning and then heading through the afternoon, 20 to 25 mile per hour gust forecast. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, even into the weekend, could still be on the breezier side. Mostly sunny skies expected both Saturday, Sunday, with highs around 69 and afternoon temperatures close to 87.